My name is Vito Scaletta. I was born in Sicily in 1925. That little guy's me. I'm standing there with my parents and my sister Francesca in front of our old house. I don't really remember too much about the old country, except that we were pretty hard up. And then one day my father decided it was time to move away. Away from Sicily. Across the ocean to start a new life in America. Never in my life had I seen anything as fantastic as Empire Bay. It was beautiful. On the other hand, I'd never seen anything filthier, more disgusting than our new shithole of an apartment. The American dream. It was more like a nightmare. My father started working at the port for the guy who arranged our immigration. It was backbreaking work, and what little money he made mostly went towards booze. Eventually, my parents sent me to school. I had to learn English. I sure as hell wasn't gonna do that in a neighborhood full of Italians. That's where I met Joe.
Come on, Vito, hurry it up. We ain't got all night.
Over time, Joe and I got to be best friends. And since we were both poor and there wasn't much work around, we started a little business of our own.
Freeze! Police! Stop!
Vito, this way! Throw me to bed! Stop! I'm gonna shoot!
Shit.
Okay, you bastard. Spread your legs.
Fuck.
And put your hands on the fence.
I'm sorry, Vito.
Well, that one time it didn't work out so good. The year was 1943. America was at war, and the army was looking for guys who spoke the language to help with the invasion of Sicily. I was 18, and anything seemed better than jail. Who says you can't go home again?
Operation Husky. I was assigned to the 504th Parachute Infantry. On the 11th of July, we were supposed to be dropped over the southern coast of Sicily, but we got hit by flak and had to bail out, way behind enemy lines. Only three of us made it. If it wasn't for the local resistance, we wouldn't have had a chance. So when Mussolini soldiers came into the town and started rounding everybody up, we decided to return the favor.
Se nessuno parla, quest'uomo morirà.
No, per favore, no.
All right, Scaletta, take the
allora,
shot.
Allora, traditori, pensavate di poterci...
Prendere in giro? Di tradirci? Avete pensato?
Everything up in that channel. Don't get me started. Behind the sandbags.
Hey, stick your food country up your ass!
They're falling back. Let's move!
On me!
Shit! Get up here!
Ammazzarsi, le zappare prigioniere per macchiare l'esercito.
Corporal, this guy's saying there's more troops headed this way.
Terrific, all right. You and Williams take out that machine gun nest. Then find the prisoners. We're gonna need every man we can get.
Amabue!
Ain't getting through this way.
Looks like we found the machine gun.
Watch it!
Fatti vedere!
If you got a grenade, Scaletta, this would be a great fucking time to use it!
Put a grenade through the window!
Scaletta, you alive?
Yeah, just about.
Well, then get off your ass and let's move it.
Whoa. Oh.
Look at this shit.
On the stair!
Hey, Greaseball! Catch!
Must have the prisoners upstairs.
Pull you to the second floor. Scaletta, you take point.
Eat shit! Got him.
The door, Scaletta. Kick it in.
Arrenditi. O gli faccio saltare il cervello!
Shit! Looks like we're going this way. Come on.
Oh, shit!
I can't see it!
Fuck it! Get your
fucking shield! What the hell?
Oh, my God! Hey,
let's talk!
What?
Hey! Fine by me, asshole!
Take off! Golden!
You guys had enough yet?
Ammazziamo le donne! Shit! This balcony isn't gonna work!
We gotta keep moving! Get inside!
Look! Get inside, Scaletta! We're gonna die out there!
Altri fascisti! Arrivano altri fascisti! Montano un forti!
Let's go!
Get out the machine gun!
Now you are deal!
See that gun on the balcony, Scaletta? Get on it!
Mandiamoli all'inferno!
Take out the truck!
Dicevo al mio amico di stare attento.
Fregatene di fare attenzione, fai ciò che ti è stato detto!
Davvero, Don Calò?
La guerra è finita!
Cacetto, un congè quando si amareta come cucina.
Ma chi è quello? Lo conoscete?
Lo conoscono tutti. Don Calò è un uomo d'onore.
È uno stupido trucco degli americani, non ditemi che gli credete!
No, è davvero Don Calò. Ogni tanto dovesse ascoltare i consigli di noiacci del posto. Ci rendiamo.
Sapete che potete fidarvi di me. Che ne dite, eh?
Don Calò, the head of the Sicilian mob. An entire garrison of troops surrendered that day. Why? Because he told them to. A few years later, the Nazis put a bullet in me. I was in the hospital for a bit. Then I got a month's leave so I could go home. At least for a little while.
Vito! Over here!
Joe!
Hey! Welcome home, buddy.
How'd you know?
I got my sources. Come on, let's take a ride.
Nice car.
Comes with the territory. I know you're itching to get home, but first, let's get a beer.
Yeah, sure.
There it is. Empire Bay. Tell the truth, you miss it?
Hey, there's a bear shit in the woods. Not like this place ever done me any favors, but... anything's better than a foxhole. What's with this shitty weather?
They're saying this is the coldest winter on record. Papers say it's gonna keep up like this for weeks. Don't worry, though. A drink will warm you right up. How long's it been since we had a drink together, Vito? 2 years?
Almost three. Tony Sicelli's party, right?
Come on, Vito, come on. The last drink we had together was right after your romance funeral. Right before you shipped out. You remember.
5 minutes, we're already talking about my deadbeat father. Can we change the subject, please?
So tell me, pal, what was it like over there anyway? I kept reading the papers to see what was going on. And you know how much I hate reading?
Yeah, I know.
You guys kicked Mussolini's ass, right?
Sort of. We had a little help from a guy named Don Calò.
No shit. Don Calò. I heard of him.
Really?
You bet. I know guys like him over here. Wise guys. You work for them, you're set. Fuck with him, you die.
Nice to see you've been busy.
Yeah, and I heard you got a medal, right?
From old man Patton himself.
Whoa, so you're a real war hero, huh? And then what? You screwed a couple of Sicilian broads and came home?
Yeah, right.
The old country. Over here, you can screw anything with a heartbeat. No one gives a shit. What a country. Here's to the US of A and to having you back home.
Salud.
A salud, chindan. How come you're back? They let you out early for good behavior?
Nah, I took a bullet a couple months back, spent some time in the hospital, and now I'm on leave.
Wait. You mean you gotta go back?
What'd you think? The war ain't over yet.
You don't want to go back, do you?
Nah, of course not, but what can I do?
1 minute. Wait right here.
Both mother and daughter working for the Yankee dollar.
Hey, Giuseppe, it's Joe. Remember last week, you know, the guy's name is Vito Scaletta. Thanks, Giuseppe. All right, I'll see you later.
The situation is mighty queer, like the Yankee girl.
Okay, listen up. It appears that your injury is much more serious than it first appeared, and the doctors say you can't fight no more.
What? Oh, did you just...
Like I said, I know people. You get all the official paperwork tomorrow. When it comes to the right stamps and signatures, it's just a question of money.
You're kidding me, right? Isn't that a bit risky? It's me that could end up in a slammer, you know? And how am I going to pay for it?
I got it covered. Think of it as a welcome home present. And don't worry, the documents will be clean. Trust me.
Well, thanks.
You're welcome. Como no frade, you're like a brother to me. Now you can start thinking about what you're going to do next.
Sure. But first, I got to go home.
All right, you want a ride?
No, thanks. I want to walk around a little, see what's changed since I've been gone.
No problem. Say hello to your sister for me. Come see me tomorrow. We got a lot to talk about.
I can't believe you just got me out of the service. Thanks again.
No problem.
I'll catch up with you tomorrow.
Here we are.
All right, thanks. Keep the change.
The weather outside is frightful, but the fire is so delightful. And since we've no place to go, let it snow, let it snow, let it snow. Man, it doesn't show signs of stopping. And I've brought me some corn for popping.
Vito!
The lights are turned way down low.
Yeah, we'll be right
let
back.
Let it snow, Jimmy. Let it snow. When we finally kiss goodnight, how I'll keep going out.
You know,
what's up, man?
Hold me tight. All the way home I'll be warm. And the fire is slowly dying. And my dear, we're still goodbye. But as long as you love me so, let it snow, let it snow and snow.
Hi, Mama. I'm back.
Vito, my boy. My boy's home. I just never see you again. Francesca and me, we wait.
Hey, sis, what's going on?
We wait for you.
Yeah.
Sit down. You must be hungry, Vito. Francesca made you a special dinner, zuppa di pollo. It's good for you.
Wow, looks good, Frankie.
It's a shame your papa didn't live to see this. He would be so proud, Vito.
Yeah, sure.
Vito, you know better.
Sorry, Mama, sorry.
Benedice, Signore, pronunciata per la tua volontà. Stiamo ricevendo, provvide nel culo vicino di noi.
Per Cristo nostro Signore. Amen.
You should get some sleep. Your room is just like you left it.
I'll see you 2 in the morning.
this ain't gonna cut it. I gotta find a place to stay.
So you have to go back soon?
Actually, looks like I won't. Joe's taking care of it for me.
Joe, you want to get into trouble again?
Mama, would you rather me go back and get shot again?
No.
Exactly.
No.
Joe probably saved my life.
Promise that you won't get in any more trouble with that, Joe. You know, your papa used to work for this man at the waterfront named Pappalardo. He's in the union. You could talk to him, work hard like you were your papa. Talk to him. Please, promise me you go talk to him today.
Okay, Mama, okay, I promise.
Grazie a Dio.
I don't give
I'm
a
sorry.
Damn. I don't care
we'll get
if you
the
gotta
money.
Sell everything
I
you got. What the hell's going on here?
Vito!
You mind your business,
no.
Asshole.
Oh, yeah?
Come on, Junior. I'm gonna take you to school.
Oh, tough guy. Scaring a woman, huh? Come on. Show me what you got.
Vito, please. You're making it even worse. What are you doing? Please, Vito, this isn't your problem. So you have to go back?
I don't give
I'm
a
sorry.
Damn. I don't care.
Come on, Junior. I'm gonna take you to school.
Oh, tough guy. Scaring a woman, huh? Come on, show me what you got.
Vito, please. You're making it even worse. Stop, stop, please. Vito, what are you doing? So you have to go back.
Come on, Junior. I'm gonna take you to school.
Oh, tough guy. Scaring a woman, huh? Come on, show me what you got.
Vito, please. You're making it even worse. Stop, stop, please. Vito, what are you doing? Please, Vito, this isn't your problem.
So you have to go back soon?
Come on, Junior. I'm gonna take you to school.
Oh, tough guy. Scaring a woman, huh? Come on. Show me what you got.
Vito, please. You're making it even worse. Stop, stop, please. Vito, what are you doing?
Ah, fuck this.
Yeah, that's right. Get the fuck out of here.
You're gonna be sorry. The both of yous.
What the hell was that all about?
I'm sorry, Vito. We didn't want to bother you with this.
Bother me? Bother me with what? Come on, tell me what's going on here, Frankie.
Right before he died, Papa borrowed money. A lot of money from a loan shark. Thinking he'd get a better job and pay him back. We found out right after you left for the war.
How much?
$2,000.
What? Shit.
The worst thing is, this guy wants it all back by the end of this week. Otherwise, the debt goes up again.
I ain't gonna make that kind of money working at the port. Who is this guy?
I don't know. Mama won't tell me. It's okay, Vito. We'll manage somehow.
Don't worry. I'll take care of this. I promise.
Thanks, Vito. Take care of yourself.
I gotta get my hands on $2,000 fast. I bet Joe could help me out.
Excuse me, ma'am. Do you know where Joe Barbaro lives?
To the right of the stairs,
And tell him that racket last night has to stop. If he don't like it, he can find another place to live.
Not at all. Come on in, let's talk.
You disgusting pig.
I picked up these broads on my way back from the store. I've been waiting. All right, girls, that's it for now. I got business. Stop by tomorrow, okay? We'll pick up where we left off. Chop, chop.
Come on, Joey. Why do we have to stop when we can all have fun?
The fun's over, baby. Later, I say. Me and Vito here haven't seen each other for a long time. We got a lot of catching up to do.
Looks like you're doing okay, Joey boy.
Not bad. I tell you, that little Spanish broad is fucking wild. So how'd it go at home?
Good. Mama wasn't thrilled when I mentioned your name, though. You know how she is. She wants me to get a straight job.
You're gonna look for one?
I don't know. But I sure as hell ain't gonna make the same mistake my old man did. I gotta pay off his debts, then get back on my feet and get my own place. I need to make some real money, and punching the clock ain't gonna cut it.
Hey, you can stay with me as long as you need to, and we'll find you a job where you can make good money without killing yourself, all right?
Music to my ears. Right now, I'm living off the 20 bucks the state gives me every week.
I know lots of people who pay well for a risky job, so to speak. I'm sure I can line something up for my oldest friend. The working man's a sucker, that's for damn sure.
You said it.
Okay, step one. I gotta introduce you to Giuseppe so we can pick up them discharge papers. Let's go.
You made enough cash for all this in the last 3 years?
More like the last 3 months. I barely had time to... furnish the place.
3 months? Holy shit.
You just gotta know the right people, and you're all set. Cause you know me. Go ahead. There's plenty of hot water.
This is where I'm gonna sleep?
Yep. All yours.
Whoa, look at this bed.
Hey, I don't know how you did things in the army, but here it's only one man to a bed, all right?
What, are you kidding me? After seeing the two broads that just left, I wouldn't touch that thing if you paid me.
Thought about what you're gonna do now?
You said you were gonna introduce me to that guy Giuseppe.
No. I meant, you know, the big picture. When you was over there, didn't you think about what you was gonna do when you got back?
Nah, not really. Well, besides the usual, you know. Find a nice girl, settle down.
Whoa. Hey, there's gonna be plenty of time for that shit later. Right now, I'm gonna make sure you live a little.
Hey, thanks again for that thing with the discharge papers.
Hey, all I did was make a phone call. You can thank Giuseppe when we go pick him up.
Hey, you think I could,
What? Drive, Vito? The roads are icy. You ain't never drove a car before.
Joe, I was driving almost the whole time I was over there.
Yeah, but this ain't no tank, Vito. This is one of the nicest cars money can buy.
I didn't drive a tank. I drove a Jeep.
What the hell's a Jeep?
It's, never mind. You gonna let me drive or what?
All right. Here's the keys. Just be fucking careful. All right, when it's cold as fuck outside, you gotta give it a little more gas than usual. That's the pedal over there on the right.
I know, Joe, I know.
I gotta get
home. But baby, you freeze out there.
Say, lend me your
it's
coal.
It's up to you.
Okay, now make a right here. Then just go straight for a while.
Down a bit. No need to get pulled over for no reason.
Hey, Vito, you know what time it is?
It's daytime. How the fuck should I?
It's time for you to get your own fucking car.
Yeah, I'd love to, if I can afford it.
Who says you're gonna pay for it?
The Big Three in the European city of Yalta, not to be confused with his previous meeting on the Italian island of Malta. The president, along with Winston Churchill, persuaded Soviet leader...
You know, you wasn't kidding. They really taught you to drive over. At least something good come out of it.
This meeting, the Soviets had only declared war on Germany. It's not known what President Roosevelt promised in return, but Stalin has pledged the full support of the Soviet armies in the war against Japan within 3 months of the surrender of Germany. For Press Radio News, I'm Lord.
Hey, Vito, if you don't want to drive no more, just say so. No need to get your balls all twisted here. You know what? You're hopeless. That's it. I'm just gonna wait here till you come to your senses.
Excuse me, ma'am. Do you know where Joe Barbaro lives? You made enough cash for all this in the last 3 years?
More like the last 3 months. I barely had time to furnish the place.
3 months? Holy shit.
You just gotta know the right people, and you're all set, because you know me. So you thought about what you're gonna do now?
You said you were gonna introduce me to that guy Giuseppe.
No. I meant, you know, the big picture. When you was over there, didn't you think about what you was gonna do when you got back?
No, not really. Well, besides the usual, you know. Find a nice girl, settle down.
Whoa. Hey, there's gonna be plenty of time for that shit later. Right now, I'm gonna make sure you live a little.
Hey, you think I could,
What? Drive? Alright, when it's cold as fuck outside, you gotta give it a little more gas than usual. That's the pedal over there on the right.
I know, Joe, I know.
Okay, now make a right here. Then just go straight for a while. Hey, whoa, slow it down a bit. No need to get pulled over for no reason.
I gotta go away. Evening has been that you dropped in. So very
hey, Vito, you know what time it is?
It's daytime. What the fuck should I?
It's time for you to get your own fucking car.
Yeah, I'd love to. Afford it.
Who says you're gonna pay for it?
Now, really, I've got to go.
You know, you wasn't kidding. They really taught you to drive over. At least something good come out of it.
To be had out there. I wish I knew.